Go.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the third round of the wine study for today. So basically, today we are going more in details on the Germany labeling terms in terms of credit card wine and credit card wine. My name is Justin, and I'll be the presenter for today. So for the learning outcome and also the assessment criteria, basically, for the hour for today, at the end of the class, you should be able to define the meaning of German labeling terms and describe the style, and also the quality of the wine associated with these terms. Then for the assessment criteria, at the end of the class, I will be asking you a few questions where you will be able to identify the grape varietal for the labels, for qualitat wine and also the credit card wine. And then you'll be able to describe the style of qualitat wine and credit card wine. I've already separated into a category over here. Cabernet, Specialisé, Archilisé, Grand Archilisé, Tropical Marine Archilisé, and also the ice wine. So, and also, I'll show you on the comparison so that you can compare the style and quality on the Cabernet wine, and, qualitat wine and credit card wine. So let's go to the next one, just to have a quick check on you guys. So, on your German wine knowledge over here. Any of you tried German wine before?
So, yeah. We tried German wine before in restaurants.
Oh, you tried German wine in a restaurant before. That must be a very, very good restaurant because a lot of restaurants in Malaysia, they are selling German wine. So, Robin, do you know the Germany produce mainly what kind of wine over there?
I'm not so sure about it.
No, not sure. Okay, Jason, so you, since you say that you tried it before, so what kind of wine do you think you should produce?
I think most of them are white wine.
Most of them are white wine. Brilliant. So what grape varietal you will usually see on the bottle when it comes to a German white wine, Veronica?
Riesling.
Okay, very good. So what impression actually you get from the German Riesling there?
Usually it's high acidity with fruity characteristic.
So it is high acidity with fruity characteristic. Alright, since you all have a little bit basic and equipped some of the knowledge on German wine, today we'll go more in details on the German labeling terms. So on the next slide, basically I'll tell you about the two qualitat wine and also the credit card wine that you have. So the first one, like I said earlier on, is qualitat wine. And the second category will be on the credit card wine. And then when it comes to credit card wine, you have six other subcategories, which is Cabernet for the first one, and then Specialisé, Archilisé, Burn Archilisé, Trockenburn Archilisé, and also the last one will be the ice wine. Alright, so when we come to the next slide, first we start about the credit card wine. So over here in credit card wine, like the six basic Riesling. So in the book that you get from the WSET Level 2, behind the label, it's written there that a qualitat wine basically is a basic or the beginning of a quality wine from Germany. And usually in this qualitat wine, they have to come from the 13 wine region in Germany itself, or the other way they call it is the 13 Arbeitsgebiet. So this is a German term that we use. Arbeitsgebiet is a region that we have in Germany for that can produce a qualitat wine. So most of the qualitat wine, they are literally light in body and high acidity. Okay, and then the character of it is usually very fruity and refreshing. Okay, because it's a so-called a basic quality wine that you have. So usually it's something that is very, very easy drinking. Okay, the style is light body, high acidity, fruity. And often it's produced in dry style. Okay. Over here I have two pictures from Dr. Luzon. Dr. Luzon L, and then another one is Dr. Luzon L Riesling Dry. So basically when you have a Riesling Dry at the back, basically means that the wine actually has lesser sugar remaining in the bottle. So I call it Riesling Dry. That's the term I'm using. Okay, so now let's proceed to the next one, which is the credit card wine. In credit card wine, we actually categorized based on the sugar level in the grapes itself. So and they actually have six categories in total. So start from the bottom, then we have the Cabernet, First one, Specialize, Auschlese, Brennan Auschlese, and Chokumura Auschlese. You can see that the aberration over there, Brennan Auschlese usually used quite a BA and TBA for Chokumura Auschlese. And Auschwein is in the second in another category. I'll tell you why, reason. Okay, so over here is from the bottom to the top, it's actually based on the sugar level in the grapes. So the bottom one actually has the least sugar level in the grapes itself. And then when it goes all the way up, you have more sugar level in the grapes. Okay, let's see on the next one. So over here, for this tree, from Cabernet until Auschlese, they are under the dry wine style. Okay, they are under the dry wine style, and for BA and TBA, they are noble rock instruments. They are considered as a dessert wine, as a sweet wine. Okay, and same goes for Eiswein, it's also a sweet wine, but in a different category by using frozen grapes. Over here, this soup is by noble rock influence, and Eiswein is frozen grapes. And on the style itself, I'll tell you on the next slide how is the style different from each other. Okay, so let's start with Cabernet Specialese and also the Auschlese. So first one, Cabernet. Basically, if you look back at the pyramid previously, it's located at the bottom of the pyramid. So basically means that Cabernet usually has the least sugar amount compared to Specialese and Auschlese. And hence, it actually has less sugar inside the wine. Okay? So Cabernet, the style is usually very, very light in body. High acidity with a lot of grapefruit notes like apple and grapes. This is a basic character style of a Cabernet. And then usually it can be a medium sweetness with black alcohol, but also at the same time can be dry with medium alcohol. If you look at the books from WSET level 2, it actually have this phrase over here, medium sweetness with black alcohol, and then dry with medium alcohol. It actually depends on the producer whether how much alcohol they want to left in the wine. So how it goes is, if you have less alcohol, means that you are sweeter over here in a German wine over here. And then when you have more alcohol, means that you are drier in style. Okay, because during the fermentation itself, the yeast will actually eat the sugar. And when they eat the sugar, they release alcohol. So the yeast actually, if they eat more sugar, then they release more alcohol. That's why the lesser sugar you have in the wine, it will become drier style, higher in alcohol. Then if the yeast actually stop the fermentation, they eat lesser sugar, means that they have more sugar in the wine, then you have lesser alcohol, they produce lesser alcohol, which that's for the Cabernet. Okay? And after that, you have the second one, which is a Specialese. A direct translation basically is called late harvest. Specialese, usually you have a heavier body compared to a Cabernet. And also, when it comes to fruit character, okay, you evolve into a more sweeter fruits or more riper fruits we call. We have some citrus and also exotic fruit notes like lemon and pineapple. And the last one, which is the top pyramid of the dry wine style, is that Auschlese. It actually has a heavier body compared to Specialese and Cabernet. Okay? And then you have even riper and stronger exotic tropical fruits kind of character inside like pineapple and mango. And then it's considered, like I say again, it's the highest category in dry wine style, even though most of the Auschlese are medium sweet and sweet. Okay? The reason why is because they are still considered dry wine style. It doesn't go through any botrytis, and also it's not frozen grapes. Okay? So these are the three style from dry wine style in German labeling terms. Okay, so if you look over here, you can see that usually in the label you can find the labels written Cabernet, Specialese, and Auschlese. It's very, very easily identified, especially for this few, this German Prädikat wine. Okay, let's go to the next slide, where we'll talk about BA and TBA. Over here, you can see that same thing, both from Dr. Lucen, you can see that the Brennan Auschlese and Trockenbrennan Auschlese, which is located on the label itself, easily identified. Now, I'm going to talk about what is the difference between BA, TBA. So basically, Prädikat wine, when it comes to BA and TBA, they are a sweet wine that being influenced by the botrytis scenario, or we call it a noble rot. Okay. So basically, what happened is because the sugar, okay? The maximum they can produce is up to Auschwitz level. If you want to go higher sugar level, you have to have the botrytis. Only the botrytis can help the wine to create a higher sugar level. Okay, because of the ripening, it will make the grapes become smaller, more concentrated when they're being unchecked by the botrytis. So the character of VA and TVA, okay, so usually the character is very, very intense botrytis character, and then dry fruit notes, like dry crops and raisins, and then medium body. Okay, it's slightly heavier, going to be heavier than Auschlitz or Spätzle or Cabernet. Most of them are low in alcohol, okay, and very high acidity. Even though it's very, very sweet, it's still high in acidity. The difference between a BA and TBA is TBA is actually being dried even longer than the BA, and TBA can only be produced in a certain very, very good year. Okay, and it's more rare compared to BA. Even the character, also the same thing, TBA is very, very intense, more intense compared to BA. And the character, the complexity, everything will be more than the BA. That's the TBA style. Okay? Now, let's go to the next one, which is ice wine. Okay? So ice wine basically literally indicate ice wine itself. If you see from the slide, it's indicate ice wine. And same thing like any other of the labeling terms, you can find it on the label. You'll put that in the ice wine. Okay? So basically, ice wine is a sweet wine made from frozen grape, which has intensely concentrated sugary grape syrup. The reason why it's being that way is the grapes is not being influenced by botrytis, okay? But they were being left on the vineyard until winter. And when you actually take the grape itself, it's still frozen. When you compress, the juice came out, it's sugar syrup. Very, very concentrated sugar syrup and liquid. The other liquid they will separate away and you get a very, very pure, what we call the pure sugar grape syrups over there. And that's the reason why after fermentation to make it become an ice wine has a very, very pure character. Very, very nice, refreshing, pure character. And often come with pronounced variety of fruity flavors. It depends on the producer. It can be a beeswax, okay. Honey suckers, honey flavors, okay, and then again very, very high acidity. And Auberge ice wine has a heavier body compared to BA and TBA, okay, and then same thing, the sweetness is syrupy sweetness Auberge. So when you talk about cabinet all the way to ice wine, the difference is Auberge, Spätzle, and also cabinet. These three are under dry wine style. After that, BA and TBA, they are under botrytis influence. And ice wine is standstill, which is using by frozen grapes. The heaviest body usually is the ice wine. Okay, and then after that come will be the BA and TBA, and then the lightest will be, you know, Auschlese, Spätzle, and Cabernet. Okay, and all this wine, they are very, very high in acidity because Riesling are planted in Germany. Germany actually very, very cold climate, that's why you get a very, very high acidity. Okay, so next, any question? Top. Okay, I have a question for you. So Jason, can you tell me that Pradipa wine that is light in body with high acidity and carry great fruit notes?
I think that will be Cabernet Riesling.
Cabernet Riesling? Very good. Which is Cabernet Riesling. Now, Robin, second question. Describe the character of an Auschlese.
Auschlese usually has high acidity, mm-hmm. and full of citrus and exotic fruit notes, which carry flavors like lemon and pineapples.
Brilliant. Can you tell me the two labels in Pradipa wine that affect by botrytis?
Probably will be Baron Auschlese and Drucken Baron Auschlese.
Not too bad pronunciation. Very good. So Veronica, which Pradipa wine has a very pure, pronounced variety of fruity flavors with high acidity, full body, syrupy sweetness?
That will be ice wine.
Ice wine, superb. Now, one last question on the next slide. What is the wine designation for this label over here?
It's Auschwitz.
Very good. Which is over there. Okay. So at the end of the day, the objective being achieved, you are able to identify the meaning of Germany labeling terms, describe the style and the quality of the wine that associated with this term. Okay, so next we will be tasting the German wine. So let's go for a break. Thank you.